Please be seated. And a very warm welcome to all of us here today. And those who are watching online, a very warm welcome to you as well. We said this year, please be planning to be able to join us in person. But we thank the Lord that we are here together to worship Him, praise His name, to hear His word, to share one another, to have fellowship, to meet one another. I believe the fellowship is not just the time that we have here on a Sunday morning or that Sunday evening. Fellowship is continuous whenever we meet and talk to one another. But this, of course, is the time that we gather together as a family of faith. The usual notices, of course, we need to pay attention to them, please. If you're able to, as you have any reason under the government guidelines, please do wear a mask or some kind of face covering. I think that's very important for us all. It's not just because the government says we should, but it's important that we do that for all of us here. Please sanitize your hands when you come in if you haven't done so. And we are not passing a collection bucket around for obvious reasons. So please, if you wish to make an offering, there is a bucket at the back where you can place your offering. Ask the welcome people to show you where that is. And the last note, which I will repeat when we come to time of communion, we will share the bread, we won't share the wine again because we can't be share the common chalice at this time. But let us just be careful how we come forward to receive communion together. Otherwise, you're welcome, and we thank the Lord for here. We're going to continue with our praise, our worship, with our next hymn, our next song, or worship the King, all glorious above. Please stand if you're able to, and let us sing the song in worship.
Heavenly Father, you sent your Son, Jesus Christ, to make us ready to meet with you. Send your Holy Spirit on us now, we pray, that we may hear your word, share in your communion, receive your grace, and renew in your love. Amen. From the rising of the sun to its setting, my name is great among the nations, says the Lord. An invitation to our profession, the grace of God has dawned upon the world through our Savior Jesus Christ, who sacrificed himself for us to purify people as his own. Let us confess our sins together, again on your yellow sheets. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things done and left undone. And so uphold us by your Spirit, that we may live and serve you in newness of life, to the honor and glory of your name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon us, pardon and deliver us from all our sins, confirm and strengthen us in all goodness, and keep us in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The special prayer for today. O God, who by the leading of a star revealed your only Son to the people of the earth, mercifully grant that we who know you by faith may eventually see your glory face to face, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord. Amen. And we'll continue with prayer and praise. Richard and Joseph will lead us.
Yeah, my God. We've already started, I think, the worship of the second Lamb Sing song. I think actually began with both our gathering song on I Believe in Jesus and those first three verses to a worship the King. We actually sang that hymn as the opportunity last week. And we chose to sing it again today, because we're just coming out of that end of Christmastide. Later on today, Robert's going to be speaking to us about the wise men visiting from the east and that great epiphany as they realised that this babe that they saw before them was worthy of all the worship that had led them to this place. So our songs, our first two songs today were of praise, affirmation and belief, and we continue that now as we sing of a blessed name, as we sing of a firm foundation, as we shout to the north of Jesus our Saviour. It's a great time to stop and reflect. What's been our epiphany this Christmas time? What new things have we learned? How have we welcomed the light newly into our lives, fresh from 2021 to 22, fresh from any other year? What's been new for us? What's been our light moment? Let's possibly reflect on that in our songs today, and as we listen to Robert speaking to us later, as we pray together. But I invite you to stand with me if you're able as we sing these three songs of blessing, worship, and majesty. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Oh, Pressure for the beam. This is to be for all the original, but I have you're reading in the area. Children, if you share what we have learned today, or what we enjoy after Holy Communion. So please stand, let us sing our theme song on the new religion.
Gospel is taken from Matthew chapter 2, verse 3, from verse 1 to 12. Hear the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Glory to you, O Lord. The Magi visit the Messiah. After Jesus was born in Bethlehem in Judea, during the time of King Herod, Magi from the east came to Jerusalem and asked, "Where is the one who has been born King of the Jews? We saw his star when it rose and have come to worship him." When King Herod heard this, he was disturbed, and all Jerusalem with him. When he had called together all the people's chief priests and teachers of the law, he asked them where the Messiah was to be born. "In Bethlehem in Judea," they replied, "for this is what the prophet was has written. But you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah. For out of you will come a ruler who will shepherd my people Israel." Then Herod called the Magi secretly and found out from them the exact time the star had appeared. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search carefully for the child. As soon as you find him, report to me so that I too may go and worship him." After they had heard the king, they went on their way, and the star they had seen when it rose ahead went ahead of them until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they were overjoyed. On coming to the house, they saw the child with his mother, Mary, and they bowed down and worshipped him. Then they opened their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to go back to Herod, they returned to their country by another route. This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise be to you, Lord Christ. Please be seated. There is a recurring word, should I say, word of theme, in the passage that we've just heard. Worship, worship. It just keeps coming back. And we tend to use that when we do the service every Sunday in other contexts as well within the church. We come to worship God. Are you here to worship God? Yes? Okay, good. And most of us, of course, put on our Sunday best. I think this is where the phrase, that term for the Sunday best came from. We adorn ourselves as we come before God to worship Him. And the image of worship in the Bible is something that, if you look very carefully, there is a sense of reverence. In some situations, there's a sense of fear. There is also a perfection, a sense of perfection. Presenting yourself to God, you don't just come before the Lord anyhow. You come before the Lord in a particular way. The Psalms tend to repeat some of this stuff as well. It says, you know, come to the Lord, come before the Lord with thanksgiving and praise as you worship the Lord. We worship God. So, the Magi, we're looking at the Magi today. Now, today is not Epiphany Sunday, it's the first Sunday of Epiphany. We actually celebrate, if you follow the lectionary, Epiphany is celebrated either on the 2nd, well, for this year it would be the 2nd of January, or on the 6th, which was Thursday. So this is the first Sunday of Epiphany, when we think about the story of the Magi. And this story has endured through many, many centuries, many, many years. Why do we hear this story? Because there is something very unique in this story. This story speaks to you and me. Now, is anyone here blessed? Anybody blessed? Okay, just a couple of people here there. I don't know if people online, I don't know if you're blessed. One or two people here are not blessed. Are you blessed, brothers and sisters? Yes. I think everybody should put their hands up. Where do we get that blessing from? Well, we heard the story of Abraham. What did the Lord say to Abraham? He said in the reading that Justin read, the Lord said to Abraham, go from your country, your people, and your father's household to the land I will show you. I will make you a great nation. I will bless you, and you will, I'm sorry, I will bless you. I will make your name great, and you will be a blessing. I will bless those who bless you, and whoever curses you, I will curse, and all the peoples on the earth will be blessed through you. Are you blessed?
Yes.
Okay, guys, everybody should put their hands up. If you are in this building, if you come here to worship the Lord, if you come here to lift up the name of the Lord, you are blessed. And that blessing is from here. So you are very much a part of this story. Now, when we think about the Magi, well, the Magi are part of that lesson, because the story is not just for the people of Israel, not just for the Jews and the people that the Lord started working with, but the blessing was for everyone, the whole earth, people from all over the earth, people from different parts of the world, from the north, south, from the east, from the west. And we are all blessed because of the blessing that God gave in the covenant with Abraham. Let us think of context here. I think that the story of the Magi has many different implications. I think that the story of the Magi, or I mean, we tell it so many times, we have a picture of that in the Nativity scene,
at the back. The story of the Magi has many different levels, I would say, aspects. I think it is a story of prayer. Why do I say that? It's a story of a prayer journey. The Magi came for a very, very long way, and I believe that they have been researching and finding out more about the scriptures, the Hebrew, the Jewish scriptures, and searching to find the truth for them, to find the truth about life. And somehow the story they found was about this little baby to be born somewhere. And in their quest, they made a very long journey from wherever they came from the east, the Bible says, all the way where Jesus was. And I think for me, it's a kind of an invitation of prayer, a searching, looking for. You're looking for something. And they were looking for something. They were looking for this promise that God had given humanity. That's one aspect of this story. The other part, the other aspect of this story, I think, is the fulfillment of prophecy. We have looked at the reading, as I said, where there is a blessing from Abraham, and the blessing comes to everybody else. Well, that blessing is for us. It's the prophecy that is given to us too. But in Matthew chapter 8, it says, I say to you that many will come from the east and the west to share in the banquet of with Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob in the kingdom of heaven. We are part of that story. Many from the east, come to the east, many from the west, many from the north, and so on, all coming together to this place, a place of worship, a place of praise and honor to God, a place where we feast with God, a place where we interact with our God. That's another aspect. And to add to that, in Malachi, he said, for my name will be great among the nations, from where the sun rises to where the sun sets. In every place, incense and pure offerings will be presented in my name, because my name will be great among the nations, says the Lord of hosts. The blessing, the prophecy, and the revelation of God's heart and love for his people is that they will gather and offer incense and prayers and worship to him as well. Another aspect is the giver. Well, the people who were given, the Magi, they came with gifts. Now, if Tolu, my brother Tolu, is one of the wardens here, decided that at Christmas or any time during the year, Tolu, remember it's not only for Christmas, you don't need to wait for Christmas, you wanted to bless me with a laptop, okay, Tolu, you're listening, Henry? My birthday is coming up late, sometime during the year. This is just if, but it's hypothetical. You don't get worried, Tolu, but the laptop will be fine anyway. So if he decided to bless me with something like that, there's something about Tolu giving me this laptop that says something about you. It says something about the person who is giving this thing. At Christmas time, we give gifts, don't we? Yes or no? Yes, of course, we give, chocolates, biscuits, whatever, clothes, etc., etc. We give gifts because we probably love the person we give the gifts to. Is that true? Yes, of course. We give gifts maybe because we appreciate the person we give the gifts to. So there's something about the person we've given in this story as well. Something about the giver giving these gifts. The other aspect is the person who receives the gift. Well, you can look at it in two ways. Firstly, what kind of gift are you giving this person? Now, we give different types of gifts. You might give somebody a very expensive gift, and then you give somebody else a less expensive gift. It depends on what you think that person means to you, right? And what that person receives. But if the person receiving the gifts, something about that person makes you give a particular gift. Perhaps what they mean to you, how they have influenced your life, possibly. And I'm
I'm not suggesting that if you give a gift that is less expensive, that is not as important as a gift that is more expensive. No, I'm saying there is something, a person who is receiving the gift, that is a part of this transaction, a part of this conversation. The person receiving the gift probably deserves the gift in a particular way, and there is something about them that makes them receive that particular gift. Okay, so let us think about this. Imagine, just use your imagination. A group of billionaires. Let's shout out the name of any billionaire that comes to mind. I don't know if you know anything. Sorry?
Bezos.
All right, I'm really split. Yeah, there you go. Okay. Something else?
Bill
Gates, yes. Yes, Musk, yes. Imagine these guys. Sorry? You're there. I apologize. I missed you there. Okay, we have a billionaire in our midst. Leave her alone, please, okay? The wardens will speak to her later on. Leave her alone. Now, imagine Musk, I think it's famous, is it? Okay, right. Yes, well, imagine these guys come together and they go to a place. Just imagine a place, maybe, I don't know if anybody has been to Brazil, but imagine the favela in Brazil. Just think of, the favelas in Brazil. And a small house in the favelas in Brazil, a little boy, a baby was born now, he's about 2 years old, and these guys, very powerful, very rich people, decide to go to this favela to give this little boy, whose father is, a cleaner maybe, or whatever he does, not the most important, not the most glamorous job. They go to this home to give this little baby a gift of gifts. And whatever these guys will give, they will select, they will choose whatever that gift may be. But they think that this little baby deserves to have these gifts, because there is something about the baby in the future that is indicated by the gifts that they give. Just imagine, use the imagination. I think this is the picture we have with the Magi coming to visit this little baby, Jesus. The Bible does say that Jesus was about, this was 2 years after he had been born, so he may have been about 2 years or so. Okay, he wasn't a baby in a manger and so on. Some of the stuff that we see in the nativity processions and scenes may not give you the most accurate information. But he was about 2 years old. And they came to give him these gifts. And what do they bring for this little baby? They bring, help me out, they bring gold. Okay, anybody seen gold?
One or two of us,
yes. Okay, gold. They bring frankincense, yes. They bring three gifts. They bring gold, they bring frankincense, they bring myrrh. Let me just think about this, think about myrrh for a second, right? Imagine you have a baby shower. Some of us, some here, are going to have babies soon. But you have a baby shower, and someone comes to the baby shower with a gift. And it's a large gift. And you open the gift, and what they have brought is a coffin. Not very, very nice. I don't think it's funny. I don't think it is, there is no humor in that. Whichever way you can twist it, it is not funny. But just think about myrrh. We'll come back to that in a second. Just think about the myrrh. Right, they bring the gold. They say gifts of gold. Containers, may have been actual gold, trinkets, and so on. They bring gold to this little child. Remember what I said before: the person giving the gift and the person receiving the gift. Why did they bring gold to this little baby? I believe they thought that this little baby, from their research, from what they thought, what they believed, this little baby was going to be a king. And that's why Herod got all upset. Because the rumor went around that the Messiah has been born, who was going to be king, his descendant of David, he was going to be king. And so, what are the Magi doing there? confirming that they're affirming the fact that a king has been born. Wow. So they have come into the presence of a king. Yes. Jesus indeed was to become king. What was the first thing he did as he started his preaching? The first phrase he used was, "The kingdom of God is here. The kingdom of God has come." Jesus indeed was a king. I watched something yesterday, the film King of Kings, and something struck me. Yes, he was a king, but he was a king who wore a different type of crown. He didn't wear a crown made of gold. He wore a crown of thorns. Remember that. He was a king, yes indeed, but a king who wore a crown of thorns. Jesus is the king of our hearts. Is Jesus the king of your heart? Okay, the one or two. Thank you, Kathy. I appreciate that. Okay. Not everybody's awake this morning. Let me try. Is Jesus the king of your heart?
Yes.
Are you sure?
Yes.
Are you absolutely sure? Because if he is the king of your heart, do you obey that king? If he's the king of your heart, do you obey that king? Do you come in reverence like the Magi and bow before him? A little baby in a, I don't know what sort of accommodation, but in a poor part of town, a little baby, you come and bow down before this king with all your heart. That is God. Frankincense. They bring frankincense to this little baby. What is he going to do with frankincense? Play with it, put it in his mouth. Little babies are 2 years old, like putting a lot of things in their mouths. And if you're going to have a baby soon, just be aware of that. Start practicing on your heart. But they love putting everything in their mouths. Okay. What's he going to do with frankincense? Where again the child is receiving it. He's receiving a gift, indicating something about him, telling us about who this child is. This child is going to be the high priest. He's going to be have a priestly role in his life. Jesus is our high priest. And the Bible speaks about that a lot in Revelation. He is seen as the high priest who receives all our prayers in the heavens. Jesus is our high priest. I am wearing these clothes and I have the title priest. But Jesus is your real priest. I am in the role to point you to him. That's my job, to point you to him. Not to myself, but to him. That's my job. Because he is the high priest. And he takes your prayers. He takes your offerings. And he offers them to the Father. Jesus, our great high priest. Myrrh. What does that mean? Well, myrrh was a kind of oil that was used for specific purposes. Medicinal purposes. As ointment in different contexts. But it was also used for embalming. When a person died, they would wrap them up, they would put myrrh in their bodies, embalm their bodies. I think someone once said, the word myrrh probably comes from the word mara. If you remember the bitter water at a place called mara, something about the bitterness of its myrrh, I can't verify that. But myrrh was given to this baby. Why? Because there was a prophetic call upon his life. A prophetic call to die. He was brought into this earth to just live and live and live and live. He had a very particular purpose. He came that he would go to the cross. Why did he go to the cross? Because of your sin. Because of my sin. Now you might say, oh, I'm a good person, I'm okay. Yes, but you have a sin nature within you. And that sin nature needed to be dealt with. And Jesus, preparing himself, this myrrh, in preparation for his death later on in his life, was given to him as a gift. Three gifts, very unique. One, for a king. Two, for a high priest, a great high priest, an eternal high priest. Not as the Bible says, not as the priesthood would be there 1 year after that. Every, the high priest that went into the Holy of Holies every year. The priest who went into the Holy of Holies, who lived in the Holy of Holies, who was himself in the Holy of Holies itself. He was our, is our great high priest, not God, is our great high priest. And thirdly, a prophetic call upon this child, and a boy born to live and to die on the cross for each and every single one of us. What gifts do you bring him today? What gifts can you bring him, honestly? What can you, you remember the song, what can I give? If I were a shepherd, I'll bring him some sheep. If I were whatever it was, I'll bring him this. Well, whatever you are, what gifts can you bring to him? Read your money, but your money is not enough. Is it, gold? Not really, it doesn't really suffice. I think the best gift that the Lord wants us to bring to him is us, ourselves. Come before him, come to him as you are. Come to him as you are. Yes, but Robert, I am not good enough. I don't know how this and I don't. Really? Are you sure? He is expecting you to come to him because he made you. He created you. And all he wants is a relationship with you and with your family, with your communities. He wants you to come to him. He wants you to be a part with him. He wants you to share your weaknesses, your strengths, your good times, your bad times. He wants to laugh with you. He wants to cry with you. He wants to walk with you. He wants to go through the difficult times. Please, guys, God is not just for church. God is for every single situation in our lives. And Jesus is with us in all those, whatever they may be. Amen? Hallelujah. Amen. Tolu is going to lead us in some prayer.
Gracious Father, your name is blessed, and we know this. And because of this, Father, we know that your Son, Jesus Christ, is our strong deliverer. And as sinners, as we come into your presence, we know, O Lord, that if we were to be righteous, if we alone to you, we shall be saved. That we pray, Father, that you will save us this day. Most gracious one, you are our strong tower. And Father, we pray that you will grant us strength as we lead our day-to-day lives. God, in your mercy. Father, the gift of your Son Jesus Christ to us shows us that you, God, you are really Father, we pray, because we have a hope in you. We have a hope in the world. And Lord, because of this, we pray that our living hope may be such that will be perfected by the power of your Holy Spirit in our lives. Lord God, your word is faithful. You are mighty and you are power. We pray, O Lord, it's your right strong hand of power that you will deliver us in Jesus' name. We come to you, Lord, just as we are. And we pray that you will accept us, because all that we have is all that we can be. And that is what we offer, Father. We pray that you will make us whole. Lord, in your mercy. The Lord said to Abraham, go from your country, your people and your father's household, to the land that I will show you. And Lord, as you promised Abraham, we pray that you, Father, will come us and make us a great nation. We pray, Father, that as you bless Abraham, as inheritances of Abraham, Father, we pray that Father, you bless us and abide with us in all our days. We pray that you will make our names to be great, O Lord. And we pray, Father, that your blessing will continue to abide with us and overtake us in Jesus' name. We pray, Lord, for whoever calls us, that Lord, you will do unto them as it conquers your wish, O Lord. And Father, we pray that the people of this world may be blessed through us. Because you are a blessing unto us, Father, let us continue to be a blessing unto the people around us in Jesus' name. Amen. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
Father, we pray for those who are sick. We particularly remember Andrew, later case among those of them. We bring them to your presence, Margaret and Benedict. We pray for Marcia, Elena, pray for Michael, Isaac, and Les. We also present your name hands over to God's Christopher, Mary's brother, who is receiving chemotherapy. Father God, we pray also for all who suffer from coronavirus, and we pray that the rise in infection will come under control. All this we ask, Father, in the name that is above you, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Lord, in your mercy, most merciful Father, we remember Mona's brother who died recently. We pray for Mona and her family at this difficult time as they prepare for the funeral in February. We remember also Tom, in the Benjamin's husband, who died recently. We pray for me and her family that God will give them comfort and peace at this difficult time. We continue to pray for Jack, who lost her grandson Harry recently, and for Kenneth this morning. May the Lord grant them both peace and comfort as they grieve his death. We pray for Lady, who lost her cousin, John Brad Barrington, recently. We remember her and her dad as they grieve for John's passing. We also remember all of our St. John's Church family and its relatives of our church family who have died over the last year. We remember all who have died as a result of the serious coronavirus outbreak in the world. And we pray to you, God, for comfort for the grieving families. Lord, reconciliation. That as they struggle to leave the world of leprosy, that the power of the Holy Spirit will continue to work in them in Jesus' name. God, bring your restoration. We pray that you bring your restoration to those who suffer, and you will redeem them all in the power of your Holy Spirit. Lord, in your mercy, as we gather in your presence this morning, God, we pray, your righteousness shall we be established. We shall depart from oppression, for we shall not fear. And we, Father God, shall be far from terror, for it shall not come near us in Jesus' name. As we march forward in this new year, Father, we pray that no weapon that is formed against us shall prosper, and that every tongue that rises against us in trouble shall be condemned in the power of your Spirit. Lord, in your mercy, we pray for our church as we plan to replace the ingredients, that the Lord in your Spirit, who abide with all that will be involved in this selection process, such that all decisions taken at the end will be such that will bless your holy work in the name of this marriage in Jesus' name. As visitors come in from the east, they are in peace for the little baby in the manger. Throughout this year 2022, Lord, we pray, let the world bring us gifts of life, gifts of joy, gifts of peace from its four corners, and let us find freedom before men in Jesus' name. All this we ask in prayer, being confident of this very thing, that he which hath begun a good work in us, perfect it until the day of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen.
May we stand and share in the peace. Our Savior Christ is the Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and of peace, there shall be no end. So brothers and sisters, may the peace of the Lord be with you. And also with you. Let us share with one another a sign of peace. Peace be with you all. And peace be with you, those watching online. The peace of the Lord be with you. We are going to sing our next hymn, which is To God Be the Glory, Great Things He Has Done. This is also our offering to him. As I said earlier, if you wish to make an offering, there is a bucket at the back. Ask the welcomers, they'll show you where it is. So, To God Be the Glory.
Thank you.
substance of our hands. We thank you, Lord, for these gifts. May they be used to glorify your name in this house and beyond. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Please sit for a meal as we join in the Eucharistic prayer on your yellow sheets. Those watching online, all prayers are on the website. Eucharistic prayer on the yellow sheets. The Lord is here. The Spirit is with us. Lift up your hearts. We lift them to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give thanks and praise. It is right to praise you, Father, Lord of all creation. In your love, you made us for yourself. When we turned away, you did not reject us, but came to meet us in your Son. You embraced us as your children and welcomed us to sit and eat with you. In Christ, you shed our life that we might live in him and he in us. He opened his arms of love upon the cross and made for all a perfect sacrifice for sin. On the night he was betrayed, at supper with his friends, he took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to them, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Father, we do this in remembrance of him. His body is the bread of life. At the end of supper, taking the cup of wine, he gave you thanks and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in remembrance of me." Father, we do this in remembrance of him. His blood is shed for all. As we proclaim his death and celebrate his rising in glory, send your Holy Spirit that this bread and this wine may be to us the body and blood of your dear Son. As we eat and drink these holy gifts, make us one in Christ, our risen Lord. With your whole church throughout the world, we offer you this sacrifice of praise and lift our voice to join the eternal song of heaven. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. As our Savior has taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one body. We invite any community members of any Christian churches to come forward to receive communion. If you do not wish to receive communion, you can still come forward and receive a blessing. On this occasion, we are not sharing the cup on the chalice again. I will drink the wine on behalf of the congregation until such time as we are given permission to do so. Please do follow the advice of the ushers as they need to come forward so that we keep ourselves in order. So brothers and sisters, draw near with faith. Receive the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which he gave for you, and his blood, which I shall partake on behalf of the congregation, which he shed for you. Eat and drink in remembrance that he died for you, and feed on him in your hearts, by faith with thanksgiving. Thank you.
We pray in harmony.
see. May we who, with the wise men, have been drawn by your love, recognize the glory of your presence in your Son, the Word made flesh, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. In prayer, ask for communion on your yellow sheets. Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Set us up in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. Amen. We have some notices, and I'll start with the first notice, which is bands of marriage between Nikolai Stachev and, please forgive me, Lachazara. Okay, I hope I got that right. They are here in the congregation. You're welcome. You're very welcome to join us today. I published the bands of marriage between Nikolai Sanchez and Lachazara, whatever, of this parish. This is the first time of asking if any of you know any reason in law why they may not marry each other. You are to declare it. Amen. Let us pray for this couple. Father, we thank you for this couple. We ask you that you may bless them as they embark on this journey together and come before you to receive your blessing. We ask for peace in their home, peace in their lives. You be their light in all that they do. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. More notices come. Okay, now the next notice is actually quite important, and for those online, please take note as well. We made an error in the sermon series on the 23rd of January, but the reading is Matthew chapter 6, not Matthew chapter 7, and that's from verse 30 to verse 34. There was an error, we put chapter 6, I'll change that for next week. But it's Matthew, sorry, I put chapter 7, but it's Matthew chapter 6, from verse 30 to 34. Can you see that in the new sermon series for this month? I'm also asked to remind those who want envelopes, giving envelopes. Some of us give online, we give maybe standing orders, others give using envelopes. In an envelope and each week or whatever, you put your offerings in that. If you want to continue with that, please do speak to Kay at the back, stand in front of the table, have a chat with her, give her your name and details, and we will prepare the envelope for you next week. Or you can come to the church office and pick up your stuff. So speak to Kay after the service. Other notices are quite straightforward. Most information is on the sheets. There, the women's group apparently, I think this is the announcement here. Your meeting after the service, is that correct? Aya? Well, it says 9th of January. So the women's group are meeting after the service. If you have any doubts, speak to Aya. She should know. But all the details are there if you want to do a meeting on Zoom as well. If I've got that wrong, my apologies. Speak to either Bridget or Ian about that. Okay, and everything else I think is quite straightforward. The evening prayer continues this week, and all the details are here. If you log into St. John's Facebook, you get all the details there as well. We meet at 6. Just on St. John's Facebook on the website. Okay, any other notices before I do the birthdays? I think the children, yes, Theo.
Slight error, just correction there.
My fault.
We meet at the cafe at 11 o'clock, say half 10 for prayer, and then we go outside at 11 o'clock for the outreach itself.
We need more people to join the evangelism team. Yes.
Yes, volunteers and teachers.
Okay. We also need volunteers for blind aspects. We often come in and the seats are clean. Everything is in order. But some people do that. They come in on a Saturday and spend some time doing it. I think it's usually about an hour or so for anybody. If you wish to volunteer, please come in. We don't have professional cleaners in the church, but you volunteer and come and clean the church every Saturday. Speak to Bridget. Yes, Bridget? Yes? Sorry? Oh, yes, speak to Bridget and you put your name on the sheet when you are able to do this. Alright, so please speak to Bridget and she will sort that out for you. Okay, any other notices? I think let's do the children's stuff first, and then I'll do the prayer place. Yeah. Let's do the children's stuff first.
Yeah. That is something I shared with the children today, and then I'm going to also share with you. So what we are doing from this Sunday, we are doing a video. For the children did the video with Fei-Wei and also Sammy, and to get what we learned. What is the relationship between Sammy and David? So finally, it is amazing. Samuel and not David as the king. Okay, so that is the story we learned. So next week we will continue this series with Fei-Wei, Samuel, and also the giant fight. Okay? So I stop here and I hope to see all the children next week. Thank you, Jaya. I just asked her to come up and then support me to share this with you. Thank you very much.
Okay, birthdays. Alright. Dear Victoria. Oh, happy birthday to Victoria Amor. Happy third birthday. Before you clap. And happy birthday to Jordan Amor, the twins. Happy third birthday as well. Give them a round of applause. And then, birthday to Ifeoluwa, Ifeoluwa Aina, I hope I got that correct. Happy birthday to you, your fifth birthday. Amen. Estelle Dianhall, are you here, Estelle? Happy birthday, your sixth birthday. Yeah. Emmanuel Blaise, happy sixth birthday as well. Emmanuel, are you here? Yeah. Okay, this is my mom. And she's my mom. Fine. And then other birthday, Sharon Davis. Is Sharon here? Happy birthday to you, Sharon. Sarah Piora. Sarah Piora. No? Kinsley or Luca, I think we'll get it later on. I hope it is. If not, please forgive me. Kinsley or Luca, are you here this morning? Okay, if you're watching online, happy birthday to you. Runya, Runya Raro Akoni. Runya Raro, yes, happy birthday. Runya. Happy birthday to you. And Janet Agatiata. No? Okay. Happy birthday. Finish here? Yeah. Alright, happy birthday to you, Dan. If you're watching online, happy birthday to you. And anybody else? Any other birthdays? Any other birthdays? Yes? Sorry? Pauline, yes. Right this one. Happy birthday to you, Pauline. If you're watching online. Yes? Anybody else? Yes, in the corner? You need to speak louder, can't you? Who? Melissa. Samantha. Happy birthday to you, Samantha. And anybody else? Any birthdays? Sometimes it's inside. No? Okay, Jaya. Please play for us the song. Okay. Love and to serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen.